bit of a progress report. Now Disco dropped into their rehearsal room this week for a friendly chat.
It's like you have to start again, you know. It's like we feel like that we're like a new band now, you know, and that like all our other songs like are gone. Do you know what I mean? It's like we have to better them. It's like the impression I have like is that we're never ever going to play our new song, our old songs again. Like, so we just have to
even though we are
like, but yeah, you know, we just have. It's just like starting again. That's what it's like, because you just want to. Write better songs so you can throw out the old ones, hopefully.
Especially like since the, since we started writing this album, like, I mean, it's like we're just a new band in a jamming room again, you know? Because, I mean, we like this is the first interview we've done in like, you know, 8 months or something. And like, we haven't done any gigs, like, and, you know, like, we're not getting recognised as much as we used to, like, so, I mean, we're just like a new band starting. Like, we feel like a new band, and that's probably good because, I mean, if you're hungry for like adulation and success, like, it means you're going to work harder to try and achieve.
Yeah, it's like so. as if we never had any success at all. Do you know what I mean? You kind of forget the whole thing that like that we were successful. It's just that's in the past, like, and you just live for now, like, and like we're a new band, like.
The good thing about this time is that, like, you know, we stopped touring and we stopped doing gigs and that. So like, you know, we're only concentrating on the album now. I mean, the last album, like, we were kind of touring, and then we'd be writing songs for a month, and then we'd be touring again. It was like, I think it's easier this way.
Yeah. Well, I don't actually.
Don't you?
Because I like the balance of you know, you do tours, and then you start writing songs. But you know, when you have to write all songs for a year, like, it's a lot of work. Like, do you know what I mean? So, but like the other way, there's a balance, like, you know.
You feel more at ease here, you know. It's like, I mean, London is a bit too fast, like, and that, you know. It was like, it's fine, like, for like, you know, doing the gigs and stuff. But I don't think it's good for writing. You know what I mean? Like, it can be okay, maybe in the summer or something. But I mean, there's something about London in the winter. It seems a very sad place, you know. And it's like, it's not. It's not very inspiring, really, you know.
I know.
begrudge the press that much, you know, because, I mean, the thing is, I gave up reading the newspapers or the music magazines and stuff like that, because, you know, I don't believe, like, anything they write, whether it's good or bad. Like, we just carry on doing our own thing. Like, we don't really care. Well, we do care, like, but we don't really mind what they say, like, because you just have your own opinion in your head of what your music is about, like, you know.
It's just all part of the game we're in, you know what I mean? It's just the same as any other, like, profession or job, you know what I mean? There's a set of rules there, and the whole thing is played by them rules. Like, I mean, we weren't, despite what everyone thinks, like, I mean, I don't think we're that naive, like, maybe we are, but, you know, we know, like, the way the whole thing works. Like, I mean, I think everyone knows, like, but, you know, it's like, they build you up and knock you down and build you up and knock you down. I mean, it's happened, like, bands like U2 or REM, like, 100 times, you know. But you just go away and you come back with something better than you've done, and, you know, you get built up again and then you get knocked down, and it's just part of the game, really. But I think, like, fans, like, don't take any notice of it, you know what I mean? Anyway, so, I mean, you know, if someone is into a band, they're into a band. Like, I mean, kind of, I always liked REM, despite what anyone said about them, you know. And, I mean, you two there, I mean, they just go away and they do their own thing, and they keep coming up with something new, like, and, I mean, they've, like, had probably more bad press than good press, like, over the last, like, 10 years, I'd say. Like. But still, like, they're selling millions of records, so someone must like them, you know what I mean?
What I'm more interested in is, it's like trying to write better songs, do you know what I mean? Trying to, like, develop as a band, like, you know what I mean? Rather than the success part of it, like, I honestly am, like, you know, my ambition is, like, just to try and write brilliant songs, do you know what I mean? And, like, whether the success comes or not, like, well, it's handy, like, if the success comes, you know, but if it doesn't, well, it's a bit sad, like, but, you know, our main buzz is from, like, when a song comes right, you know, we do a song, like, that we're very happy with, that there's nothing would beat that, you know?
It's still amazing, like, to get a chance to go up on stage and play your songs to people, you know what I mean? The fact that we're allowed doing that, alone, like, is, like, you know, an amazing thing for us. I mean, because when we started out jamming, we thought we'd never get the chance to play live, like, to two people, you know what I mean? And yet we've got the chance to play in front of, like, thousands of people, you know what I mean? And it's, you're like, you know, they're our songs, like, and we're playing them to people, like, and, you know, people are enjoying them, like, I mean,
But it's great, like, to be able to express yourself as well, do you know what I mean? Like, through music, like, you know what I mean? Because otherwise, I mean, it's very frustrating, you know, sometimes, like, you might have something that's been bothering you for months in your head, and you can't, you even don't know what it is, like. And, like, when you write a song, it comes out, like, do you know? And then it's a release, like, do you know what I mean? It's almost a kind of form of therapy. I think they always were very personal, like, do you know what I mean? In a way, like, but it's, I mean, it's more the feeling than, than the words, you know? That's what I think the most important thing in music is the actual, like, the melody and the whole feeling that you're trying to get across. It doesn't matter about the words, like, so much. You use them, like, as, like an extra colour or something, you know, that you have, like, if you're an artist or something, painting or something, they're an extra colour.
I think actually, like, as you progress, you actually get more confident with lyrics too, you know. I mean, there's like, if you feel something, and, I mean, half the time you're afraid to put it down on paper because it might make you look silly or something, you know. And if you're heartbroken, like, I mean, you don't want to tell the world, like, so you disguise it maybe. And, I mean, the more songs you write, the more confident you get with lyrics, like, so I suppose the lyrics I mean, that we're going to have in the new songs, I suppose they're going to be stronger, maybe, you know what I mean? I mean, I don't think we're afraid anymore to hide things, you know what I mean?
That's the whole thing that holds you back is your kind of pride that, you know, you're afraid to admit that you feel this certain way, you know what I mean? And that's the whole thing that'll hold your progress, like, lyrically, you know? You have to kind of forget about your pride and, like, bear yourself naked to the world, you know what I mean? Like, for them, like, to, you know, to knock you, like, and say, oh, you're a fool, like, because you wrote this in a certain song, do you know what I mean? Because, you know, they know you're bearing your soul, like, you have to, because you have to be honest, like, you know, because you can spot, like, contrived music, like, a mile away, do you know what I mean? You can just spot it, like.
Hopefully we'll be a bit nervous, because, I mean, it helps, you know? I mean, if you go into a record meeting or a record company meeting and, like, some guy says, you know, if you're nervous, like, you're going to get your point across more, you know, because, like, these record companies, they have, like, all strange ideas, like, about how things should be run, and they never seem to work, you know? So, you know, you're better off having a bit of an edge, like, it's the same with gigs. You do your best gigs when you're, like, feeling a bit uptight, like, you know, you seem to express yourself better, yeah. But we're not afraid to go back over, like, by any means, you know what I mean? I mean, we weren't afraid the first time we did it either, you know? Like, we always just looked at it and said, well, if we get somewhere, we get somewhere. If we don't, we can always come back here. Like, it'll be the same this time around.
The Frank and Walter is very much busy writing and rehearsing their second album at present, should have an EP out on Go Discs sometime early in the summer. Moving right along then from one manic pop thrill to another, from the album Submarine Bells, this is The Chills with the appropriately titled Heavenly Pop Hit.